Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about unitary method. We will learn what is unitary method and how it is applied to solve the problems and how it can also be applied to solve problems in the real life situations. Now let us look at example number one. Now in this example, it is written, if the cost of one orange is rupees 10, then what is the cost of 10 oranges? Now here what we do is, in unitary method, we have two cases. One case is going from one to many. Like in this example, what we are doing is we are having the price of one orange and we are going to get the price of many oranges, more than one. So this is the case of one to many. In the second case, in the second example, we'll be having a case of many to one. That means we are having the cost of more than one oranges and we have to get the cost of one orange. So this way, we are going to learn how unitary method is applied like this. So in the first case, it is cost of one orange is rupees 10. So when we are going from one to many, what we do is we multiply. So here, there is multiplication. The cost of 10 oranges will be rupees 10 into 10, which is rupees 100. So this is how we have obtained the answer for this particular example. Now going to the second example, as I said, this is a case of many to one. So here, if the cost of 5 oranges is rupees 50, then what is the cost of 1 orange? So we have the cost of 5 oranges, which is more than 1. Now we have to come to 1 orange, the cost of 1 orange. So then the cost of, here the cost of 5 oranges is rupees 50, the cost of 1 orange will be 50 divided by 5. When we are going from many to 1, we are dividing. I mean, we are using division. And when we go from 1 to many, we use multiplication. So let us go to the third example, which is a mixture of case 1 and case 2. Let us see, if the cost of 3 oranges is rupees 50, then what is the cost of 21 oranges? Now here in the first case, I mean applying the first case, what we do is, we are going from many to 1. Like we have the cost for 3 oranges, the cost is rupees 50. So what we are going to do is, now we will be obtaining the cost of 1 orange, that is going from many to 1. So cost of 1 orange will be 50 by 3. As we are going from many to 1, we are doing division. So 50 by 3 is the answer for this. But this is not the actual answer. We want the cost of 21 oranges. So for 21 oranges, now again we are going from 1 to many. That means we have obtained the cost of 1 orange. Now we have to obtain the cost of 21 oranges. So for 21 oranges, going from 1 to many, we'll be getting 50 by 3 into 21, that is multiplication, we are going with multiplication, and that is rupees 350. Okay, now let us look at example number 4. Now this is an example from the real life situation. Now as you all can see, the example goes like this. 90 men can complete a work in 24 days, working 8 hours a day. Now the first statement says that there are 90 men required to complete the work in 24 days, working 8 hours a day. In one day they are working for 8 hours and they are requiring 24 days to complete the work. Now how many men are required to complete the same work in 18 days working 7.5 hours a day? So now in the second statement they are asking us to find out the number of men who will be required to complete the same amount of work in 18 days working 7.5 hours a day. Now let me tell you one thing, that whenever you are using unitary method, what you have to do is, whenever you are framing a statement like this, when in the solution we are framing a statement like to complete the work in 24 days, working 8 hours a day, number of men required is 90. What I have done is I have written what is asked in the question at the end of the statement. You have to put whatever is asked in the question at the end of the statement. It should never be in between the statement. Always, whatever is asked should be mentioned at the end of the statement. Now here, to complete the work in 24 days, working 8 hours a day, number of men required is 90, because we have to find the number of men required in the final answer. So we have mentioned it at the end of the statement. Now, what we are going to do is, we will be applying here. Now here, there's a little difference. Here you have to apply a little bit of your common sense. Now to complete the work in 24 days, working only 1 hour a day, number of men required is 90 into 8. Now here, even after going from many to one, that means from 8 hours to 1 hour, we are going with multiplication. Why? Because whenever you're reducing the time, you will require more number of men to complete the work. If the time is more, number of men required will be less. That is very easily understood. So here, number of hours are reduced in a day. So number of men required will be more. So we are going with multiplication here. So 90 into 8. And then in the second statement, to complete the work in one day, working 1 hour a day, number of men required will be. Now, since here one day is needed, I mean, we are going from 24 to one day. Again, the time is reduced. I mean, the number of days given to the men is reduced. So the more number of men will be required. So we are again going with multiplication. So here it is 90 into 8 into 24, which is 17,280 men. So many men will be required to complete the work, just working 1 hour a day, 1 hour a day. Okay. Now to complete, now what we are going to do is we will be solving the final situation in this particular question. Now to complete the work in one day, working 7.5 hours. Now here we are going from 1 hour to many hours. So in this particular case, instead of going with multiplication, we are dividing. The reason is that when you are giving more time, you will require less number of men. Okay, you will reduce the number of men because you are giving more time to a certain number of men. So they will finish off the work in that particular period of time. So number of men required will be less. So here now to complete the work in one day, working 7.5 hours, that is 15/2 hours, number of men required will be 17,280 divided by 15/2. So now after division, I mean, when you take 15/2 in the numerator, it gets reciprocated and we make it 17,280 multiplied by 2 divided by 5. So that gives us 2304. So these are the number of men required if they are working for 7.5 hours in a day. So we have seen that when we have given more time, we required less men. So with that, we got 2304 as the answer. Now to complete the work in 18 days. Now we are again giving more time to the men to complete the work. 18 days working 7.5, that is 15/2 hours in a day. So what we are going to do again here is we have to divide because we are increasing the time. So lesser number of men will be required. The number of men will get reduced. So here the number of men required will be 2304 divided by 18. And finally, your answer is 128. So as you have seen, in the unitary method, when we are applying this particular method to the real life situations, how we get the, or we can solve the sums and we get the final answer. So number of men required here is 128 when they are working for 7.5 hours per day and for 18 days. So my dear students, do well in your exams. Apply this type of a concept of unitary method to your problems in direct and inverse variations. And do well in your exams. All the best. Thank you.